there, Pop?
What is it this time, General? A B-17, B-24, or B-38?
A B-24, Pop.
Ah, that make me very happy. Did you hear that, Mr. Garrison? That was a B-24. I won't sleep tonight unless I knew that. Pinky! I would be also very happy if the Air Force took over the barbershop. Or maybe I should change the sign outside to Scariano's Flying Foot.
Sorry, Pop, I can't help it. You see, Mr. Derrickson, just the sound of those motors does something to me. If I tried to shave you while that plane was rolling by, I'd probably cut your throat.
Watch it, Pinky.
Hey, Pinky. Here, take this 20. Go to the bank and change it. And believe me, I hope you receive it a letter very soon. Otherwise, I won't have no customer left.
Okay, Pop.
He's a nice kid. You know, he likes aviation all the time. Look, he's really young. I'm proud of him.
Hiya, Jane. Hiya, Frankie.
Hi, Jane.
Any sign of a letter?
No, not a sign. How about you?
Nope. It'll come, brother. It'll come. Don't give it a thought.
Well, I wish they'd make up their mind. It's been over 4 months now. Yeah. I can't stand the strain.
You can't stand the strain. I can't stand the strain. Did you get a letter, Pinky? Did you get a letter, Frankie? 4 months is a long time to listen to that routine.
Okay, Janie, you win.
How about coming over to Alan's house? I promised that I'd help him fix the lawnmower. We can talk about it over there.
Oh, sure. I'll come over.
Oh, okay. No, you don't. You're walking me home. You can go over to Alan's and play Junior Birdman afterward.
Trapped like a ratty game.
Hey, I have to get to the bank before it closes.
See you later, Alan.
Okay, I'll be there. Hi, Alan.
Oh, hi, Pink.
Change this 20 for me, will you? Any sign of a letter?
No. Maybe they have all the pilots they need. Maybe the war's over.
Take it easy. It takes time, a lot of time. You gotta be patient and relaxed, like me. Hey, come on, give me the 20. It's a B-17.
I wonder why I love this show.
What?
Same old walk down the same old street on a summer afternoon. We've done it hundreds of times, haven't we?
Uh-huh.
I know every house and every tree. Mapleton, Ohio is the only place I've ever been in all my life. Now you ought to be bored with it.
Uh-huh. And I ought to be bored with you, too, because I've known you all my life. But I'm not. And I know what you mean, Jane. I like it, too. Just a couple of small-town hicks, that's what we are. And I like that, too. Uh-huh.
You won't be for long. You'll be flying all over the place.
I hope so. Hey, now don't go gloomy on me.
That wasn't gloom?
Well, what was it, then? I guess I know that little face about as well as you know this old tired street. Sort of looks like the street, too.
I just wanted to make this moment stick. I don't know why. Frankie.
Yes?
No, I better not. You'd only laugh and spoil
no,
it.
No, I won't. Go ahead.
I love you very much.
Oh, for God's sakes, you... You told me that 10 years ago in public school.
That's romance. That's what you are.
Well, one of us has to keep his feet on the ground. But I like it.
I wonder what it's going to be like when we get in, I mean. You know, you read all that stuff and you talk to guys who are in. But you don't ever know what it's really like.
Like? Why, they're going to give me my little P-38 and off I go into the wild blue yonder. Just comes out of the ground for women and decorations. Half and half.
Oh, pipe down, Pink. I mean, how tough is it going to be? You know one thing we never considered? Are we going to be scared stiff that first time up in a plane, I mean?
Maybe. I even get train sick. Oh, you're set, brother. The day you get in, they strap you in.
Think of 9,000 feet. Put her into a tailspin. And if you burp, back to mama.
Yeah, and a lot of guys wash out, too. They don't all make it.
Yeah, that's true. Lots of good guys, too. Remember Bailey? Graduated the year before we did?
Oh, yeah.
Track team, football. Awful good guy. He washed out.
Oh, this is fine, fine. We're not even in yet, and you're washing us out.
Hey, what is it?
Hey, it's a B-24, isn't it?
No, it isn't.
Yeah. Sure it is! Hey, look!
Alan?
Yes, Mom?
I stopped at the post office.
Mom, is it?
Yes.
Hey,
maybe
that's it.
Huh?
Oh,
baby.
What's it say?
$3.
Come on, this is it.
Oh, just fell out.
Report in 36 hours. This is it, honey.
Yeah, I guess this is it.
I want to freshen up a bit.
Well, hurry it up, Mom. We've got a lot to talk about. Come on, sit down, honey.
I thought this little piece of paper would never come.
Alan, I want to go along with you. All the way through.
Oh, now, Dorothy.
Please, Alan, let me finish. I've been waiting for that letter, too. Only it means something else for me. It means they're going to teach you to fly, and that's less than a year, isn't it? And then you're off.
But, honey, there's a war on. We're no different than anybody else.
I know that. But I want that year, Alan. I want it very much.
Baby, do you know what being a cadet's wife means? We don't take our training all in one place, you know. Every 10 weeks or so, we move on. And you'd be living in tourist camps, flea-bitten hotels. Be alone all week, just sitting and then waiting for those 4 hours we could have together. Maybe. Oh, it's no good, Dylan. It's a rotten life, believe me.
But it's my life from now on. I want those 4 hours.
Now, look, you know what I'll be making as a cadet? We can't afford it. And even if we could, I wouldn't let you do it. Hey, Mom. Mom, talk to her, will you? All she wants to do is tag along and follow me right through training. How do you like that?
Certainly.
Huh?
Well, Dorothy and I talked about this and decided weeks ago. I'm afraid there's nothing to discuss, Alan. She's as good as packed.
Yes, but, Mom, don't you see...
Don't interfere with the four freedoms, Alan.
Some family I've got.
I think I'll set the table.
Well, I'll help you.
You stay right where you are. I'm cooked tonight. I'll call you later.
Okay, you cadet's wife. You figure out how many days 4 hours a week adds up to in a year. This is it, Mom.
You're happy, Alan?
Well, I guess you know. But you don't mind too much, do you, Mom?
Why, try not to. Alan, promise me something.
Why, sure.
You will be careful of those airplanes until you get used to them?
Oh, don't you worry, Mom. I'll be scared stiff till I get used to them.
Hey, Alan! We got him!
Down below!
We're here for it!
Hey, Alan!
Everybody stay to dinner. We're going to celebrate.
Oh. All right, I'll eat cornflakes.
Major Scariano, the citizens of Mapleton salute you and present you with a certified check for $10,000 as a hero of Ohio.
Three ranks of six men. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next man in front of the men on the end down there. Let's go. Get the lid out. Hustle it up. We got a lot of work to do. Come on. Hurry up. I'm going to give you a few simple commands. I understand you might have a little trouble with them at first, but do the best you can. You'll all be soldiers before you know it. Right? Detail. Change. Hut. F. Pace. Forward. Fire. Hut. 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 Hey. Power. Hut. 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 Hey. Power. Hut.
You will get your shot in the arms. You will get cold equipment. You're trying to get something.
Detail.
Reverse.
Hold.
We don't know where you'll go from here.
All right, cover down and file, man. Quickly cover down. I'm going to peel off these first three files. Detail. Column lift. All right, move right out.
One pair of GI shoes. Check the size. One pair of GI shoes. Pair of OD slacks. OD slacks. One blouse. That's a coat with the brass buttons on it. A field jacket.
Hey, fellas! Look! Greetings from the president!
Hey. Biscuits in the army, they say, are mighty fine. One rolled off the table and killed a pal of mine.
Oh, I don't want no more of army life. Gee, Mom, I want to go home.
Oh, the chicken in the army, they say, is mighty fine. One jumped off the table and started marking time.
Oh, I don't want no more of army life.
You six men remain right in this area. I'll be back for you later. The rest of you men, head, hey, boys, hey, cut, 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 cut,
cut. Nobody. It's not a mistake. This is the Air Force, all right. This is the wild blue yonder. You guys cadets?
Yeah.
That's what you think. You're not cadets, brother. You're just GI. You're just pre-cadets.
There aren't any planes here, are there?
Brother, you won't even get to fly a broom for a long while.
When you say that, you can whistle Dixie.
Hey, where are you guys from?
We're from Ohio.
Oregon.
Oh, I'm from Texas.
Oh, yes, Texas. Now we're going to hear all about Texas again.
Why, it's so big.
Where are you from, buddy?
Brooklyn, New York City. It ain't small either.
Never heard of it.
Hey, fellas, what's it like?
Hey, wait a minute, wait a minute. Where's Whitey? He'll tell us. Hey, Whitey, brethren, long, long ago we saw a poster. It was a beautiful poster, was it not?
Yes!
What did it say?
Join the Air Force!
Join the Air Force! Be a pilot, bombardier, navigator. Fly that fortress, fly that liberator. Get those wings, get those women. Did we join? 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, 6 months. Where's that letter? Talk flying, eat flying, sleep flying, breathe flying. Where's that letter? Will it ever come?
Yes!
It comes. Report in 36 hours. Goodbye, Mom. Goodbye, Dad. So long, sis. Goodbye, kid. Don't worry. I'll write. I'll write from Australia. I'll write from Africa. Right?
Right!
Join the Air Force and see the garden spot of Camp Murder. To the right, gentlemen, is Pneumonia Gulch. Oh. That is where we sleep. You fry by day and you freeze by night. To the left, just a little ways, just a mile and a half, is Ptolemaic Tavern. That is where we eat. The wheat cakes we leave are used by the Navy as depth bombs. And the planes, yes. Where are the planes? Ah, gentlemen, they can be seen at night in the movies. How then do we become pilots? Bombardiers, navigators, tell them.
Forward!
Forward!
Eyes right!
Eyes left!
Stay on the ball!
Stay on the ball!
Wipe that smile off your face!
Look, Frog, you're in the Air Force!
Hut two people! Hut two people! Hut two people!
So, what about that beautiful poster? With that beautiful pilot? In that wonderful fortress? Gentlemen, we have a little song here that tells it far better than any words of mine. It goes... We join the Air Force to fly machines, and all we do is clean latrines.
All that don't scare me none. Still sounds okay to me.
An eager beaver.
Yeah. What's that?
You, an eager beaver, is a guy who thinks everything is so wonderful.
If you guys don't like it, you ought to get out.
We like it fine, but we like to gripe. That's half the fun.
Hey, some men here, let's go! Home boy and money from home, take it slow, move!
Well, fellas, this is it, and I wish I was dead.
My name's Ross, Alan Ross.
Hi, my name's Miller, Irving Miller.
Glad to know you, Irv.
Well, Anderson's my name, Dave Anderson.
Hiya, Davey.
I'm from Texas.
Hiya, Dave.
I'm Frankie. Fine, fellas.
Hello, Frankie.
Hi.
Hi, Frankie. Grills, Bobby Grills.
Hi,
hello,
Bobby.
Danny Scariano, they call me Pinky.
Hi, Frankie.
Hi, Bobby. Hello, Bobby. Hi, Frankie. How are you?
Well, maybe I should have stood in Brooklyn, huh? At least if you wanted to see planes, you could go to LaGuardia Field on Sunday. they gotta let us at him sometime. I can take all this. As long as they show us a plane once in a while. I'm plane crazy. I got the bug since I was a kid. I got it.
I got it early, too. I used to stand in the cornfields and watch for planes till my eyes hurt me.
You a farmer?
No, this is the furthest I've ever been away from home in my life.
If there's a bug, what's a farmer know from flying, huh?
Well, down Texas, why, we had our own flying club.
Hey, no kidding. You mean you've flown?
Yeah, quite a bit.
Hey, you must be rich.
Well, not for Texas. My father only has about 6 oil wells at the moment.
Say, Alan, do you think I could sneak off and send a wire to Jane? I promise
you. You better stay right here, Frank. You don't get in on the first day. The sergeant said wait here.
Yes, but I told Jane I'd wire the minute I got to camp.
It'll keep. Hey, fellas, meet a bridegroom of 2 days.
Hey, congratulations.
Hey, that's great.
I have her picture here.
Yeah?
Oh, sure.
Hey, let's see.
Well, of course, she's prettier than that. She was nervous.
Hey.
Sure is tough, married 2 days. Really, only 1 day, and I can't even send her a wire.
Hey, she's nice.
Right.
Here's my ball and chain and the kid.
Gee, that's a cute baby.
Hey, let's see.
4 years old, already talks like me.
Hey, that sure is a cute kid,
all right.
Living Junior. Well,
I have a picture of my girl here, too, if you mean.
Hey, you farmers do all right.
Hey,
right.
Hey,
you think there's a chance all of us might be able to bunk together? We sort of know each other now, and that'd be swell.
Oh, fine. And we three will hope to stick together, too.
We are women. Hey, fellas, look! G.I. women!
Women!
Hey, women! Hey!
On the end of this formation. Come on, let's go. Get on.
Come on.
Was that you?
Yes, sir.
Well, don't whisper it, pilot. Say it.
Yes, sir.
What? Hurt.
Off we go into the wild blue yonder, climbing high.
Barber, I'm a barber myself. I just want you to take a little bit off the sides, but a very little bit. And on the top, I want you to leave it full, but I want you to leave it very full. I don't want you to cut it down at all.
Oh, haircuts in the army are mighty fine and set. There's more hair on the great group than they leave on your head. Oh, I don't want no more of army life. Be mine.
Allen, Albertson, Alpert, Anders, Anderson, Appleton, Ahrens, Asker, Atkins, Atkinson, Adams, Ashley.
These are written tests. They'll help determine your classification.
are you best suited for navigator, for bombardier, for pilot?
Write your name in the left hand.
Serial number in the right hand.
Answer as many questions as you can.
There are 50 questions.
You have 10 minutes for the first
test. Read all the directions carefully.
Don't delay.
Raise your hand if you don't understand.
Mark your answers clearly.
You're being watched. You're being judged.
You have 100 questions.
Yes, mister. All the points are orientated north.
Don't delay. Work fast.
This is a speed test.
You have 100 questions.
You have 1 minute, gentlemen.
Dean Bailey, Berger, Basler, Berkowitz, Bowman, Benton, Bales, Brown.
What's your mother's name?
What's your father's name?
Did you ever have measles?
Mumps, scarlet fever?
Whooping cough?
Ever have any broken bones?
Ever have any dizzy spells?
Ever get air sick?
How good is your depth perception?
Can you judge distance from a height?
Will you be able to land a plane?
Can you judge the distance between the pegs?
Align those pegs.
Ever have any dizzy spells?
Did you ever use glasses? How strong are your eyes?
Ever have any dizzy spells?
Do you see a red dot?
Tell me when the lines cross. Draw those lines together.
You'll fly at 30,000 feet someday.
40,000. Do you know what it's like?
Can you stand high altitude?
Stand low pressure?
Can you use an oxygen mask?
Watch the altitude.
You're going up now.
Is your headache? Can you breathe easily?
Do you have the bend?
Do your joints ache? Swallow hard. Clear your nose. You're going up now.
15,000 feet. 20,000 feet.
You feel
feet.
Faint.
Your nails turning blue.
Tighten your mask.
Breathe deeply.
Going up now.
Davenport, Daly, Dean, Donaldson, Dillon, Stover, Doyle, Downey, Douglas, Dodge, Dickinson, Dawson, Decker, Dunlap,
Dell.
Haul in.
On the double.
First squad, all present, count of four.
Second squad, all present, count of four.
Third squad, all present, count of four.
Squad, all present, count of four.
Look proud, you're the best, you're cream of the crop.
Keep your head erect.
Pull those soldiers back. Keep those eyes ahead, straight ahead.
What are you looking around for, mister? You want to find the place, mister?
Eyes straight ahead.
Hold your ranks.
Keep in step.
Cover down. Get your elbows in.
Cover down.
All together.
Hold the cape.
Watch that cape. Ready in step.
Get
in down.
Cream of the crop. Pull that chin
out.
Bottom left.
Right. This is a speed test. Turn the pegs as fast as you can. Turn them completely around and replace them in the groove. Turn the pegs in a clockwise direction.
Use one hand only. Keep your left hand down.
If you miss one, don't stop.
Max, keep going, keep going.
You're being watched.
You're being watched.
Don't stop. This is for speed. You're being judged.
Remember your number. Move the stick sidewise to move the top green light. Move the stick forward and backward to move the middle lights. Use the rudders for bottom lights.
Match the lights.
Line up a green light with each of the red lights.
How many times can you match them in the time allowed? Your score is being counted.
Hold the stick steady when you use the rudder.
Keep your back straight.
Don't tighten. Your score is the number of matchings you make in the time allowed.
Hold the stick steady.
You're being watched.
You have only a minute.
You're being watched.
Watch for the signal. Listen for the click.
How fast can you react to the signal?
Turn the white light out.
Push right switch when red is right. Left switch when red is left.
Blue, Blackwell, blank, Bachman, Bond, Bolton, Gould.
Aim the nose of the plane on the target. Number six, both hands on the stick. Number six, you're aiming wide. Don't kick the rudder. Relax in your seat. Hold the plane steady. Keep it level.
Your right rudder forward turns the nose right. Left rudder forward turns nose left.
Hold it steady. Watch it. Number three. Relax, relax, relax.
How's your coordination? Can you work in opposite directions? Coordinate both hands? How good are you?
What's the target?
Right handle left moves button forward. Left handle right moves button away. Left is to the right is to the forward. Left moves right. The disc rotates clockwise. The target moves with the disc. Keep the small button on top of the target.
To get off, get back on quickly.
Right handle left moves button forward. Left handle right moves button away. Left is to the right is to the forward. Left moves right.
Next. All
right,
next. Next. Follow me.
Next 4 minutes.
Pass quietly through the hall.
Quickly,
next.
Keep it at ease.
Next floor, room number 5.
Quickly, please.
Next.
Can you follow a moving target? Keep the end of the rod on the brass target. Contact the disc. Follow it. Keep your eye on the disc. Hold the correct button down at the same time.
Relax it.
Don't stand too close. Keep your wrist relaxed. Number 8, stand up straight. Number 8, don't bend your elbow.
Relax it.
Follow it.
You're being watched.
You're being watched. Keep the rod on the target.
You're being scored.
You have 15 seconds.
You have only 10 seconds.
You have only 5 seconds.
Cease. When I say ready, you will grasp the handle. When I say inhale, take a normal breath and hold it. And when I say go, your trial begins. Try to keep the metal rod free from the sides of the hole. You will note that each time the metal rod comes in contact with the sides of the hole, the light flashes on. Each flash of light indicates an error. You must at all times avoid contact between the metal rod and the sides of the hole. Gentlemen, I want to be frank with you. Far too many aviation students are being washed out in flying school who should never have been permitted to get that far. Now, the man who becomes nervous and tense in critical situations, man who gets rattled under fire, is not the man for air crew training. We shall now have the first trial. Ready. Inhale. Go. Watch the stylus. See it hit the sides of the hole. Watch each flash of light, that's all. Just keep watching. You're counting your own errors. Each flash advances you a notch closer to failure.
Stop! Write down the number of errors. You have 10 seconds. Ready. Inhale. Go.
You know that these tests will determine your classification. You know, too, that some of you may walk out of this room virtually eliminated from aircrew training.
Count those flashes of light.
Count your errors.
Mister,
watch each flash of light. They're all being recorded. You can't wipe off a single one of them. Stop. Write down the number of errors. You have 10 seconds.
Ready. Inhale. Go.
No man is a hero to himself. He can see himself failing. The light keeps winking. Watch the light. Each wink tells you you're one notch closer to final failure. The nervous man must not get the chance to endanger the lives of his companions in the aircrew. Stop. Write down the number of errors. You have 10 seconds.
Ready. Inhale. Go.
We'll go right to the left, to the right. We'll forwards, we'll backwards, we'll backwards, we'll forwards. Left, right, left, right, left, right. Ow! Hey, Pink, haven't you had enough? Let go of that cold water.
No love, no nothing.
Pink, shut up,
baby.
Will you?
No, no love, no nothing.
Listen to that guy, will you? I want to drop dead, and he's singing.
Me too.
Well, anyway, it's over. Boy, I never want to go through another 6 days like that the rest of my life.
Yeah, it's over. All we have to do is worry if we passed all the tests.
Well, I'm so dog tired, I don't think I got the strength to shave both sides of my face.
I tell you one thing, and I ain't fooling. If we do pass all those tests we took, we're just the smartest guys in the world, that's all.
And the healthiest. They've been over every inch of me at least 8 times.
Yeah. I said, what are you looking for now, Doc? Maybe I can help you. I know that department pretty well.
Hey, boy, is that the Chattanooga choo-choo?
Oh, I give up on that Pinky. He's just got no nerves at all. It was all fun to that guy, even the thing with the lights. Boy, my legs wouldn't hold me up after that one. I ain't ashamed to admit it. Watch the light. Count your errors. Every mistake is bringing you closer to failure. Watch the light. Count your errors. What did he think we were doing, playing potty?
Well, you know, we didn't have to go through any of this here stuff at our flying club down Texas.
No, no, 6 oil wells don't mean a thing here either.
I wonder when we'll hear how we made out.
I don't know, 4 or 5 days, some guy told me.
5 days? As long as that? Well, that means we won't hear until next Tuesday.
Oh, for crying out loud. Stop worrying. Relax for a minute. We only just finished today.
I wasn't worrying.
Well, then stop making us worry. Relax, will you?
I am relaxed. Relax yourself.
Kind of tough on him there, weren't you, Alan?
I wanted to be. He's sick about the way he thinks he made out in the test. We've got to keep him on the beam till Tuesday in case... Well, let's not think about that.
Hell, I feel like two new men. Hey, how about the movies, you guys? Betty Grable tonight.
Listen, you couldn't get me to see Betty Grable tonight if she was right in that shower over there.
Hey, look, don't you ever get tired, Pinky?
Not from little things like those tests, brother.
You know, I may sock him right in the jaw. That guy ain't human.
Why, you're a fool, man. You bring around a good-looking dame, and I'll show you how human I am. Why, those tests were fun, pal, fun.
You and I'm too tired to argue. Boy, am I going to hit the sack tonight. Just going to fall down with all my clothes on. So long.
All right with you, Irv.
Hey, fellas. Betty Grable with the legs.
I got to write a letter to my girl, Pinky.
Some substitute. How about it, Al? Do you good?
No.
Oh, come on. I hate to go alone.
No.
Huh?
Pink, I'm worried about Frankie.
Well, why?
About his making it. I don't think he did any too well.
Oh, he'll make it. He's made it this far, hasn't he? And you worried all along the line, too, didn't you?
Yeah.
Oh, sure he'll make it. Why? I wouldn't be the same at all without all of us. Oh, there you go, spoiling Betty Grable for me. Now I'll be seeing Frankie instead of those legs.
Gentlemen, this test will decide if you've gone crazy from taking all the other tests. If you can look into a mirror without going, you're okay.
Uh-oh, here comes our friend again. The purge is on.
Wash out tickets, mister?
Yeah, only a few tonight, though. Your luck still holds.
Thank you.
came awful close. I'm sorry, Al.
Oh, forget it, Frankie. This business is getting us all.
Yeah.
Gentlemen, you have been called before the faculty board to discuss your qualification or disqualification for aircrew training. Before we proceed, I want to ask whether any of you have objection to any officer member of this board. I assume there are no objections. It is my unpleasant duty to tell you that you have been recommended for disqualification because of an unsatisfactory adaptability rating for military aeronautics or because of some physical deficiency which has become apparent during your examination here. Now, there's no doubt in our minds but what each of you could learn to fly a plane under peacetime conditions. We are not concerned with that, but with your probable performance under combat conditions. Conditions where a slight physical deficiency may spell tragedy, or where the emotional strain may cause you to crack. Remember, each man in a bomber is responsible for 9 other lives besides his own. We will review each of your cases in order to reach a proper decision. You may now leave and await your individual hearings. Dismissed.
How I hate this job.
Who doesn't?
What's that supposed to be, Ed?
No, nothing. Doodling. I just can't stand to look at their faces when the news first hits them. I have an idea what's going on inside. My kid washed out, you know.
Well, let's get it over with. Send in Peter Clark.
Yes, sir. Peter Clark.
Peter Clark! Report to the president of the board.
Aviation student Peter Clark reporting, sir.
At ease.
Mr. Clark, I regret to inform you that your aptitude scores are too low to qualify you for any aircrew training.
Yes, sir.
We've investigated your case and found that on your first day's tests, you did exceptionally well. But your final aptitude rating was so low that we cannot let you by.
Yes, sir.
Isn't there anything you wish to say to us, Mr. Clark?
Well, it's sort of personal, sir, and anyway, I hate a guy who makes excuses.
We'll respect your confidence and don't worry about excuses. Go ahead.
Well, it's my girl, sir.
If you think you can tell us, I wish you would. I'm aware we may seem ancient to you, but we've all had girls ourselves.
Yes, sir. Well, the night before we were supposed to take our aptitude test, I got a letter from my sister. She said my girl... We got...
Was it absolutely definite, Pink?
Yeah. Yeah, they give it to me in my little P-38. Pursuit pilot. Well, that's it. You guys had better get back. You lose your passes for 2 weekends for cutting inspection.
Oh, who cares?
No use batting it around. This is it, that's all.
Look, Pink, we know how you feel, and we know you don't want to talk about it right now. But stay on the ball, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, listen to us for just a minute, will you, Pink? You know, there's something to that guff they've been drumming into us about the whole crew being a team. It's not just pilot, bombardier, navigator, and that's all.
Well, sure, Pink. Well, where would they be without the gunner and the radio man? It makes a lot of sense because they're just as important as the pilot. You know that.
Well, if this is still for you, any part of it. That's why I like to see you stay in there pitching. All right, so you won't have wings. This is bigger than that, isn't it? Isn't it, Pink?
I'll be shipping out tomorrow.
Tomorrow? They sure work fast, don't they?
Pink, will you think about what I just said? I'm not just saying it to make you feel better. It's true, Pink.
I know. Only I don't want to talk about it right now. Do you mind, Alan?
But look, Pink, if you'll
just...
Leave
it alone, Frankie.
Meet us after Miss?
Sure.
Let's go to the PX and get some beer and take it away somewhere. Away from the crowd.
Okay.
Right. Let's go, Frankie.
I'll see you later, Pink.
Gentlemen, as you know, you are here today for the purpose of receiving your classification into aircrew training as a pilot, bombardier, or navigator. When your name is called, you will come to this desk. If you do not accept your classification, retire to the back of the room, and I will hear your objections at the end of classification. And I already know what those objections will be. Right now, you all want to be pilots and nothing else but. 2 months from now, you'll wonder what in the world you objected to. You'll feel that bombardiers and navigators are the most important part of the Air Force, and you'll be right. Carry on, Captain.
Larson, Henry.
Pilot, you set the classification?
Yes, sir.
Sign here. Good luck, mister.
Slater, Edward.
Bombardier, accept the classification?
Yes, sir.
Sign here. Good luck.
Walton, Bart.
Navigator, you accept the classification?
No, sir, I do not.
Very well. Major Apple will hear your objection when classification is over.
Ross, Alan William.
Pilot, accept the classification?
Yes, sir.
Sign here. Good luck to you, mister.
Davis, Frank William.
Pilot, accept the classification?
Yes, sir.
Sign here. Good for you.
Anderson, David.
Bombardier, accept the classification?
Yes, sir, I accept.
Sign here. Good luck.
Grills, Robert Edward.
Pilot, accept classification?
Yes, sir.
Sign here. Good luck.
Miller, Irving.
Pilot, accept classification?
Yes, sir, I sure do.
Okay, Mr. Miller, sign here. Well, you made it.
Paxton, Gilbert.
Janie, if the commanding officer could hear you say it just that way, I bet we'd get 2 passes a week.
Well, Mom, I think I'll leave you here.
unless you want to be a flyer.
One flyer in the family's enough, Jimmy. You got the chocolate.
You bet. Right here. Oh, penny for your thoughts, Dad. What's the matter?
Oh, nothing, nothing. Just looking around.
Oh, say, Dad, there's our squadron commander. I'd like you to meet him. Sir, I'd like you to meet my mother and father. Mom, Dad, this is Lieutenant Stevens, our squadron commander.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Well, how do you like the way your son's looking, Mr. Gardner?
Well, I think he makes a pretty good-looking soldier, Lieutenant.
Well, I'm not quite used to it, I must say. You see, I was still thinking of him with that beautiful wave in his hair.
They treat you right at classification, Gardner?
Yes, sir. Pilot, sir.
Was he the only one to be classified a pilot, Lieutenant?
Well, not exactly. It's been very nice meeting you both. Good night.
Good night, sir.
What a nice young man. And so young to be in charge of a place like this.
Well, he's just in charge of our squadron, Mom. Well, I guess we better say goodbye. I've got some studying to do for class tomorrow before lights out, and I hate to go, but I better...
Well, goodbye, Ron. Take care, won't you? And keep writing. We love your letters, so...
Sure. Goodbye, Dad.
Goodbye, Jim. Got everything you need?
Everything. Take care of yourself, Pop.
I will. Keep up the good work, son.
You bet.
Two more weeks, and then on to primary.
Frankie.
Yeah?
Wasn't that a cute little baby in the movie tonight?
In the movie? I didn't notice any baby in the movie. Can you believe it, Jane? It's finally gonna happen. We're gonna fly. The real thing.
Frankie? You mean to say you didn't notice that cute little baby?
Huh? Oh, yeah, very cute. We'll be flying PT-13s. 220 horsepower. Can you imagine? They say, though, you've got to watch out for ground loops in them. You know what a ground loop is, don't you, Jane?
Of course I do.
Yeah.
You always used to notice babies in the movies, Frankie.
Babies? Who's talking about babies? What I was saying was it never lets up, not for 1 minute. We'll be having classroom work and flying at the same time all the way through. Be maps and charts and radio. Why, they'll probably drill that code into us until it comes out our ears. Da-da-dit, da-da-dit, da-da-da, da-da-dit, da-da-dit. Oh, what's the matter, Jane? Did I say something, honey?
No. It's just that...
Oh, of course. You wanted to talk to me about something, and I go rattling on about my own stuff. You go ahead, honey. I promise to stop thinking about flying for one whole minute.
One whole minute? Never mind, darling. You just go on thinking about flying, and we'll talk about it some other time.
Frankie!
Oh, come on.
We only have a few minutes. We better hop on it.
Okay. Good night, Doc.
Good night, Jane. It was a wonderful weekend.
Good night, Mrs. Davis. Next week we'll roll around before you know it. Come on.
Goodbye, sweet.
Jane, you didn't tell him.
Oh, Jane, you promised.
Oh, Dad, I just couldn't. He'd be sure to worry.
But Jane ought to know. He might want you to go home and stay with his folks. Having a baby under these conditions is pretty risky, you know that.
But I don't want to go back, Dad. I want to be with him. We'll be together. Oh, you'll always be there.
I'll tell him later. Not now. I'm afraid he'd make me go back. Oh, I don't know what to say, Jane. Now, you've got to take care of yourself and do what I tell you.
Of course I will. Oh, Dad, you'll see. Dad, we're not going to miss the last bus, are we? Everybody's gone.
No, we've got time. I like to wait till the light's out.
You know, I was just thinking... We're pretty lucky.
Lucky?
Well, you know what I mean. Even with the war and everything, we're still pretty lucky.
Yes. Yes, I guess we are.
733, that's Simpson Landing.
Ship landing. Pick that wing up. Pick it up. All right. So that's fixed back. Ease it back now. Hold her off.
That's it. Hold it. Hold it.
Quit playing with that stick. Hold it back and set it down.
Seven. Oh, that's seven too many even for a first night solo.
Poor Simpson. I don't want to be in his shoes when McIntyre gets round to him.
That's right.
All right, taxi in. Park that airplane and report to control.
Hi, pilot.
Hi, pilot.
Hey, Alan, we night soloed. Do you realize that, boy? We night soloed. Me that used to stand in those cornfields and watch my planes, I night soloed.
Everything looks so different up there.
I got the feeling like king of the air.
Hey, Ross, how'd you do?
Okay, I think.
Your first night solo?
Yeah, I ain't doing. Boy, I think everything else seems
safe. Oh, boy. Wow, who's that?
Sir, aviation cadet Henry Simpson reports as ordered.
Mr. Simpson, you've had about 100 hours.
Yes, sir.
3.5 months of flying. When are you going to learn something? You've been sitting up there fat, dumb, and happy, playing with a stick, making every mistake in the book. You made no attempt to listen to control. When I told you to bring your wing up, you did nothing. Instead of breaking your glide, you flew into the ground. Now, Mr. Simpson, you'd better get your head out tomorrow night and remember what you've been told.
Yes, sir.
You might also remember I don't repeat these speeches to any one cadet. He's usually not around to hear them a second time. You better get back now and turn in your time.
Hey, will you look at that guy? Take it easy, Irv. Give it to us.
Oh, don't spill it all at once, sir. Take plenty of time. Tell us all about that moon and how close the stars
are. Yeah, the clouds look like white velvet.
Oh, go jump in the lake, smart guys. I just had the biggest darn thrill of my life, and you mugs ain't gonna talk me out of it. I suppose it was just another flight
to you guys.
Why, Bobby, did we say that?
No, Irv, we just want to get it hot off your lips.
Shut up, listen. I wish I was a poet. I ain't fooling. I'd like to write it down for my kid.
This first night solo, it does something to the inside.
I ain't over it yet. Give me a cigarette.
When are we gonna load it, Frankie? He gets romantic about a propeller blade. This'll be a regular love story.
Well, it is romantic. And you don't hate yourself in the morning, either.
Ross?
Yeah?
You just come down?
Uh-huh.
Well, how was it?
Okay, it's pretty nice upstairs tonight.
Oh, get him with the tired old veteran. Go on. Listen, fellas, you're in for the biggest thrill you ever got.
What's it like at first?
Well, you're scared stiff, naturally. You can't recognize a thing. Then you relax. And, brother, you ain't seen the moon or the stars or the clouds till tonight.
I wish I were relaxed right now.
Oh, by the way, Ross, there was a letter for you, so I thought I'd bring it down. Oh, thanks, Ross. Good luck. See you when we get back from the moon.
Right.
Hey, it's from Pinky.
Oh, hey, yeah.
Dear Alan and Frankie and the rest. Well, I suppose by the time this letter reaches you, you'll all be hot pilots dangling those parachutes like medals. As for myself, I'm now at advanced gunnery school, and all I can say is it shouldn't happen to a dog. The nearest town is 62 miles away and has a population of 300. All Indians.
Oh.
Makes it very nice for weekends. The women all look like shoe leather, and my shape is better than any woman's I've seen since we got here. Movies arrive every 3 weeks by Pony Express, and the mail's flown in by carrier pigeons. Yesterday, a pigeon took one look at the camp and turned right around and went back. Why don't you guys write? Well, keep them flying, you guys. And if you need the best turret gunner in the Air Force, let me know a few days in advance. Oh, P.S. I also give haircuts on the side. Yours, Pinky.
Hey,
hunt!
Eddie. Come around here, will you?
Hey,
now, listen. I've got some bad news. One of the planes just crashed. We don't know which one. A farmer telephoned. He saw it dive into his wheat field. Now, which boys of Flight D haven't come back yet? It's one of those four planes.
Marshall isn't back yet, sir.
Stevens isn't here yet.
Now, take it easy. Who else?
Michelson.
Frankie Davis isn't back yet, sir.
Okay. Now, it's spreading over the field, and I wanted you to hear it from me. We don't know anything yet. Remember that. Maybe it's just a forced landing. When the farmer says he saw a plane dive, he can't tell what he means, so take it easy.
Sir, was there any fire?
He didn't say. He just told us where it was and hung up. He was going out there himself. There's one coming in.
Marshal! Hiya, Sid.
Well, what in thunder's the matter with you? Hey, hey, let go of the hand, huh?
It's good to see you, sir.
What is this? What is this, anyway?
One of the planes just crashed, Marshal. We don't know who.
Oh, who's missing?
I know, Whitey. The mechanic just told me.
Here comes the last.
No, Joe.
Well, it's Davis.
Captain McIntyre. May I go, please?
I'm sorry, Ross. The colonel has strict orders.
I can't just stand here, sir.
The colonel's there, Ross.
Oh, take it easy,
the colonel said he telephoned from the farmhouse. I told headquarters to put the call through down here. He's long since there. We'll know something any minute now.
Ten,
at ease.
Well, gentlemen, no more flying tonight. You can return to your quarters.
Oh, Mr. Ross, I'd like to speak to you alone.
At ease. I know, Ross. Have a cigarette.
Thank you, sir.
Sit down. Your best friend, wasn't he? Don't talk if you don't want to, Ross. I'll just sit here with you for a while. Or I'll go, if you'd rather.
No, I... Did he have a chance?
The nose was buried deep in the ground.
I just can't make myself believe it yet. I can't. It's... Well, the poor guy... His wife's gonna have a baby, sir.
Oh. I didn't know that. His wife live in town?
Yes, sir, with my wife. Did you know him at all, sir? He was such a wonderful guy. We used to...
I think I've spoken to him once or twice, yes.
May I have a pass to town, sir?
You want to go to his wife?
Yes, sir.
I'll drive you over in my car.
You're very kind.
Kind? That word kind sounds a little foolish now. You sure you're all right, Ross?
Yes, sir, I'm all right.
Good. My car's in front of headquarters.
But I'm no good down here in the ground.
Yeah, we know that. We found that.
Go ahead. Now it's our turn. You guys want to hear the truth?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, the first time you came down the flying line and I got my first look at you, I said to myself, are these the characters I'm going to have to teach to fly? My stomach did a snap roll and my brain just ground looped. You know, you're about the raunchiest looking bunch of cadets I've ever seen. And I've seen some raunchy cadets. And speaking of raunchy cadets, where's Mr. Miller?
Here I am. Here I am, Lieutenant.
A month or so ago, the first time I let Miller up for his night solo, you know I was sure he was going to fly right smack into Brooklyn? I was mighty scared, though, Miller. If you don't stop making those Brooklyn landings, you'll never see Brooklyn again.
Oh, I gotta see Brooklyn.
The Brooklyn Flash!
If you can't pass a whack dormitory without dipping your wing, you're going to get your bottom frap paid by somebody a lot bigger than me.
Were we any dumber than usual?
I wouldn't say any more than usual, but your record will stand for a good long time.
Neither can you ever think that we wouldn't make it.
Fellas, if you knew the times, I've said to myself, that bunch will never make a 20-hour check ride, you'd choke on that beer. But to my great surprise, you made it.
Yeah!
Just to get a little serious for a minute, fellas, I want you to know I'm mighty pleased.
You see, we instructors have a rotten job. We're all dying to get over there, but the Army says no. Your job's to stay right here and instruct a bunch of raunchy cadets. Well, men, that's a bitter pill to swallow. And about the only kick we get is when you guys make it. It means a lot more than you think. Because we get kind of tired and discouraged, too, you know. Yesterday, I received a letter from a kid who graduated about 4 classes ago. He's in the South Pacific now, and he still remembered me. I got quite a kick out of that. It kind of made me feel like I was over there, too. Well, what I'm trying to say is it's been swell teaching you to fly. I'm going to be sorry to see you go. You're a swell bunch, and I'm going to miss you. Yeah.
I'm a little drunk. And I'm glad I'm a little drunk because it shows it's a good party. And I just want to say how wonderful everybody is. Fellas, when I was back in Brooklyn... All right, the heck with Brooklyn. Fellas, I ain't never had what you might call a good education, so I can't use some of them big words. Say what I mean. But when you meet fellas like Bobby and Alan
and the rest,
why, that's it. It's the stuff. It's the McCoy. It's the stuff. It's the McCoy. That's it. Gee, I'm tight.
At ease, fellas. Break it up. I'm sorry, but we have to be getting back. Graduation tomorrow, you remember?
Oh. Yeah.
So we'll draw lots to see who stays here and cleans up, and the rest of us have to get back. Now, come on, let's everybody take one.
Hey, fellas, hey, we forgot.
What?
The song. Hey, Johnny.
We are little black sheep who have lost.
See that Irv gets back to the barracks, all right, will he? He's pretty high.
Sure, come on, Irv.
Marshal, I'm a little tight and I miss my kid. Did you know I had a kid, Marshal?
Nah, Irv, come on, tell me all about it.
Yeah, he's 3 years old and already he talks just like me.
All right, gang, let's hit those trucks. Come on, everybody on. Let's go.
Hard to believe, Bobby, isn't it? Tomorrow morning, wings.
Yeah. Big day, all right. Say, Alan.
Hmm?
You mind if I ask you a favor?
Why, no. What?
Well, the thing of it is, like, folks won't be coming down to the graduation.
Something wrong?
No, just can't afford it, that's all. Neither can my girl.
Oh.
Well, everybody else will be having their folks or their girlfriend there to pin their wings on for them. And I don't want to just stand there, so would you pin my wings on for me, Alan?
Gee, that's no favor, Bob. I'd have socked you if you'd ask anybody. Huh? Come on, let's line these kegs up.
Yeah.
Hey, there's still some beer left
here.
How
about it?
You're not kidding.
Well, what do we drink to, Al?
Let's drink to Frankie, Bob.
To Frankie.
Chaplain Foster will now deliver the invocation.
Dear Lord, before you stand the pilots of America. Grant them victory, O God, for they are freedom-loving men. In granting them victory, you fulfill their resolve that liberty, true and universal, shall not perish from this earth. Dear Lord, for these things do our airmen sacrifice. For these ideals do they wage war. And for these, they will achieve victory. Bless them with strong minds and great hearts, mutual faith and ready hands. May the efforts of these men and all the other men of our armed forces keep the homes of our nation secure unto the day when thy peace shall reign over all the earth. Grant this petition to us, O God, that thy name may be glorified, and all the earth shall recognize that thou art God, and there is none else. Amen. Lieutenant Sperry will now administer the oath of office.
Gentlemen, raise your right hands. Repeat the following words after me. I repeat your full name.
I, Gilbert R. Berman,
do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear
that I will support and defend.
That I will support and defend
the Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I take this obligation freely.
That I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion.
Without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion.
And that I will well and faithfully discharge.
And I will well and faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office which I am about to enter.
The duties of the office which I am about to enter.
So help me God.
So help me God.
The squadron commanders will now present the wings. You're now pilot officers, and I congratulate you.
got him on all right. Attaboy. Hey, it's Alan. Hiya, Lieutenant. Hiya, Lieutenant. How are you?
Nice and new, fresh out of the oven.
I wonder which one is ours. I sure hope they buy us a good one.
I wish they'd hurry up inside and let us know. How long can it take them to pick a number?
Hey, Dave! Billy, I got it! We've got our chef!
What's the number?
909. 909! Let's go! Come on! Hey, fellas!
Hey! Hey, Pete! Did you get it?
Sure!
What's the number?
554.
Five, we're all set.
That's good.
Yeah, this time it's for keeps. It's all our own.
Come on, let's get this
going!
Let's go!
Let's go!
Look at the baby.
Oh, how's my little pin-up girl? Home, sweet home.
Boy, I can't wait till we take her upstairs. And when does the rest of the crew get in?
We're going to meet them here, just about on the co-pilot.
Well, I hope we get some good guys.
All I can say is I hope we don't get one of those stuck-up green peas for a pilot. You draw one of them and the whole crew's flat in no time at all.
Listen, we ain't even seen the guy yet. Give him a chance. Come on, let's go, huh?
Brother, I've been excited my life. You've never
well,
seen
fellas, anything. This is the day.
It sure is.
From now on, we eat together, sleep together, fly together, maybe die together. Hallelujah, brother. This is a big day. Me, I'm glad it's here. This is it.
Isn't she a lovely lady?
Oh, boy. Well, we might as well flop down. We're early.
That's a good idea.
How long do you think before we push off? Depends, a month, maybe two. They usually want you to fly together as a crew that length of time before you make the big hop.
I hope it's that way where it's warm. You know, after the war is over, I'm going to lie in the sun for about a year and a half before I even think of a job.
Hey, what are you going to use for money, bub?
So I figure to come back a hero and charge so much a look.
Tell me, Pinky, what are you going to do?
Who, me? Yeah. Well, first of all, I'm going back home and do a little standing in front of the barber shop, just gassing about the war.
I'll bet.
Sure. Tell the customers a pack of lies, of course. How I told off the CO and brought back the plane on one engine after the pilot conked out.
Oh,
well, you know men will believe anything in a barber shop. Me and my pop will get a kick out of it. Well,
you are?
No kid. Sure, I couldn't stay in the ground after this. I got wings in my head anyway. And you know, maybe I can make it after combat flying is up. I'm going to give it a big try.
Not me, brother. It's okay now, but the day I get down on the ground for good,
I'm going to pick up a handful of dirt, put it in a bottle, and any time I feel like going up again, I'm going to eat it. I'm not kidding.
Hey,
hey,
there they come now.
Well, where?
They don't look bad from a distance.
Pipe down.
Hey.
What's the matter, Pink?
It's Alan and Irv.
You know him?
Oh, I know him. Gee. Hey, this is going to be the best crew in the world.
At ease, men. My name's Ross. This is Lieutenant Miller, our co-pilot. Before we introduce ourselves all around, will you excuse me if I say hello to an old buddy?
Hiya, Pink.
Boy, this is wonderful.
A little more respect, Sergeant. Get a load of this uniform.
Well, I think we ought to get to know each other.
Barker, sir. Engineer and turret gunner.
Barker?
Millhauser, sir. Assistant engineer and gunner.
Millhauser?
Adams, sir. Radio operator and gunner.
Adams?
O'Brien, sir. Tail gunner.
O'Brien?
Gleason, sir. Waist gunner.
I suppose the best waist gunner in the Air Force.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Say, how about storing your things in the ship and give it a once-over?
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Pink.
Yeah?
Well, are you pleased, you stinker?
I can't even catch my breath yet. How did it happen, Al?
The lieutenant pulled his rank, that's all. You're talking to a pilot, brother.
Oh, just luck and a little politics, Pink. We got it here today, and they were assigning crews.
Saw your name down for another one.
So I just went to the CO and explained that I hated to have my hair cut by a new barber.
Well, come on, Gib. What goes with you, Pink? Oh, never mind about me. You guys have the news. Tell me, how was Bobby's wedding? He wouldn't give me a pass.
Fine, but no honeymoon. She's joined him here.
Bobby's here, too?
Uh-huh. And Dave.
Hey, fellas, wake me up. I'm dreaming. So is he joining you here, too, Al?
That's right.
It's all too good. I'm due for a sock and a kiss, for sure.
Hey, Pink, you been flying with these fellas?
Oh, yeah, great bunch, sir. Great. Hey, listen, can't we celebrate this some way? We just can't let this pass. This is what we dreamed would happen way back in Mapleton.
Well, I'll celebrate after I get over my stage fright, Pink.
Stage fright?
Sure, you know what it means for a pilot to fly with his crew for the first time? Nine guys watching him like horse to see how he stacks up.
Oh, go on, Al. You're kidding.
No, I mean it. I'm scared stiff.
He's on a level, Pink, and I know what he means. It's like his girl's family looking over before they give you the okay.
Oh, well, listen. Just let one of them guys say a word and I'll break his neck.
Well, that's fine. That's
oh, okay. Everything's all right.
Wait a minute, though. What are we going to name her, sir?
Well, you want to name her right away?
Oh, yes, sir. It's considered lucky.
Okay. Anybody got any ideas?
Well, the pilot usually has the right to name her, sir.
No, let's all do it. You got a suggestion, Pink?
Well, let's see. How about the Flying Eagle?
Thanks. We ought to have something romantic, like the Tired Tomato.
Too romantic, huh? Would Out of the Blue be any good?
No.
No.
I guess not.
Hey, how about Mr. America?
You've been seeing too many movies, bud.
What about All of Us?
Sounds like a pyre ear advertisement.
Well, is it going to be funny or serious? We ought to decide that, huh?
Doesn't matter. If we hit it, we'll all know it right away. Wait a minute. I think I got it. Listen. How about the Big Chested Angel?
Are you kidding?
No, I'm not kidding. That's what a liberator is to me.
Well, you better see a doctor right away or I won't climb in the ship with you.
How do you like that? You just got no feeling for poetry, that's all.
The Big Chested Angel. I'd like to hear you explain that if we got shot down someplace.
How about This Is It?
Not quite good enough, is it?
No, I guess not.
Hey, how about the Eagle Scream?
Pink. Let the eagle alone, will you?
What would you think of this one, sir? What would you think of Winged Victory?
That's it. Boy, I like that.
Yes, sir, I like that fine.
That's it, all right.
Right on the nose, that's it.
Sounds lucky, too.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Well, the ship's got a name.
Nice going, nice man.
Hit her on tomorrow. And here's the good flying for all of us. Shall we take her up for a shakedown?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go.
How does the radio check?
Radio is okay.
Pilot to waist, over. All set back there?
Everything's okay.
Tower, this is Army 554, ready for takeoff, over. Roger, Army 554, taking off. Bring in the generators.
can't believe it. Tomorrow is the day. It's finally, this is it.
I'll believe it when that nose heads south.
You didn't say anything to the girls about our going over, did you?
No, you're not going to say anything, are you?
No, I think it's better this way.
Yeah, it's better for everybody.
Hey, listen now. Wait a minute. So I says to this punk, ours is the best ship and crew on the piece. So he says, prove it. So I says, look at the record, brother. We completed our training before anyone else.
We've never... Completed your training?
We completed our training at...
Dad, listen. They're playing our favorite tune.
Hey, what are we sitting here for, chewing a rag? I want to dance.
Wait a minute, Irv. We're all too full of food. You know, it would be fun next weekend. Let's have a picnic at the beach. We can hire out one of those little cabins by the day. We can bring our own food out with us. You used to love picnics, Irving. What about it?
Yeah, sure. Sounds swell, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, let's do it. Bobby, we haven't been on a picnic for years. Did you know that Bobby played the ukulele like a fiend?
I'm a fool for moonlight, a ukulele, and my husband singing slightly off key.
There's a little friend of mine coming up from Texas. You mind if I bring her along?
Sure, no matter.
We girls will make all the arrangements.
Right.
All you fellas have to do is to wangle one of those weekend passes. Do you think you can handle it, Al?
Set. I've been saving the excuse for a sure weekend pass. Now I'll pull it.
And whoever said I sang off key, you rat?
Come on, let's dance.
Yeah, come on.
Hey,
Hey, what about me, huh?
You just watch and learn from a couple of old married men, my boy, and no cutting in either.
Okay, Pop.
Dance. Don't just drag me around.
I was thinking about the kid, Ruby. I miss him fine.
Ah, he's better off with Mother Irving. I had to send him away. He was getting too spoiled. Too much like his old man.
Ruby.
What?
Nothing.
That's all right. You want to get romantic, save it for next weekend. Have moonlight in the ocean.
You're quite a girl, Ruth.
Look, Bobby, don't Irv and Ruth look cute? They've got their eyes closed, both of them. They're right out of this world.
Want to try?
No. I want to look at you.
Well, don't look at me that way, baby. I'll bust right out crying.
Why, Bobby? What for?
For no reason at all. Kiss me, baby. I don't care if they all stop dancing and stare.
Have fun tonight.
Sure.
Weekend will be wonderful. I'll pray for good weather. Shall I bring along a girl for Pinky Allen?
Better ask him. Todd, there's something that...
Allen, listen. They're playing that song for you boys. Sing it for me.
Honey, listen, there's
something...
Please,
Allen, sing it for me.
You know, it's funny, Al. In a few hours, we'll be making the big hop. If you want to let yourself think about it, we may never come back. So what do you think about? America with a capital A, the Statue of Liberty, democracy? Nah.
I was thinking of that afternoon. I saw the Dodgers win a no-hit, no-run game from the Giants. I'm taking my kid to Prospect Park on Sunday to watch the seals get fed. I keep remembering that one little baby seal that my kid wanted to take home. Yeah, I guess I'm just a lowbrow punk, Al. I ought to be thinking of the big things, eh? Like the show on the March of Time or something from the Reader's Digest.
What do you think I was thinking about just now? I was remembering how I used to come home from the bank on a Saturday afternoon, fool around with the lawnmower for a while until it was time to take a bath, and then stretching out in that nice tub of hot water. Dorothy calling up to me. Smell the fried chicken all the way upstairs. Boy, that smell of soap and fried chicken on a summer's afternoon is the greatest perfume in the world.
Yeah. You know what's happening in Brooklyn right now? They're giving a kid his bath. And my mother-in-law is complaining about her arthritis and swearing she's going to change over to another butcher. I'd be getting home from work in about a half hour, and I'd put the kid to bed and tell him a fairy story. I make him up myself. And on Friday nights like tonight, my mother-in-law makes a goulash with noodles that's out of this world. I can taste it right now. War's a pain in the neck, ain't it, Alan?
Yeah. The thing is, though, Irv, it's only now we remember those things. Because we're leaving them. Maybe for good. You never thought about it then, did you?
No. No, you're right. But, boy, when I put my kid to bed after I get back from this war, I'm gonna make a big thing of it. If he says, tell me another story, Papa, I'll tell him five. Pull a little song with him.
Come in.
Hi. Well, I found the bag for you. Does this one look okay for Daisy?
Yeah.
Wish I could bring Ruthie this way.
Sometimes you worry me, Irv, the things you say.
I made an oxygen mask for her. Fits her perfect, but she hates it.
Sit down. Bat the breeze a while, thanks.
Okay. Well, what time do you think we'll kick off, Al?
Well, about 6:30, I guess. Say, wasn't that a swell blowout we had the other night?
Oh, yeah, the last word. Something to remember. You know, you guys are driving me right into marriage.
Fine. Why should you escape punishment?
Oh, no kidding. What a swell bunch of girls they really are. Dorothy and Helen, and your wife, Irv. They knew it was the last time they'd see you before the big hop, but you'd never guess it. No bawling or nothing. Sweet and gay as the devil. Oh, they did a good job, those girls.
Yeah. Yeah, and they got the toughest part ahead. The waiting.
They go back?
Tomorrow afternoon, they're still in town. We didn't tell them we were taking off, but they kind of know, of course. Women always know those things.
Together.
For a guy with six oil wells, you certainly celebrate the hard way.
Listen, brother, where we're all going, you look back on a Coke is something out of heaven.
You guys been briefed already?
Oh, yeah, we pushed off in a little while.
Tough you couldn't have gotten Dave for your bombardier, Bobby. Would have been nice.
Yeah, sure would. Well, maybe we'll all meet up.
Huh? Yeah, maybe. But one thing, sure, fellas. When this is all over, why, we got to have a big reunion at my place down in Texas. Oh, I'll show you guys the time.
When this is over with Dave, you'll have to get me out of Brooklyn with a crowbar.
Okay, go. Hey, wait a minute. Somebody make a toast, huh? Alan, come on, make a toast.
Yeah, come
yeah,
on, Al.
It's kind of hard to put it into words, Bob. Sound a little foolish, I guess. Let's just all drink to what we're thinking, huh?
Something nice happened to me out of this war, anyway. You guys.
Good flying.
That goes for me, too, Pink.
Davey?
Yeah, good luck, Davey.
So long, Bobby.
Give him the works.
Thanks, sir.
Right. Yeah.
Gee, I hope it.
What? Oh, nothing.
I guess I better finish this letter.
Well, I think I'll go down to the ship for the last once over. I'll see you later, okay?
Wait a minute, I'll go with you, okay, Adam?
Sure.
Get a load of that sunset, will you? Old Lady Nature's certainly given us a fine send-off. Come here, Pink, take a look at it. Isn't that something, huh? Our last American sunset.
I thought it was going to be red, white, and blue the way you were carrying on.
You got about as much sentiment as a cockroach. Take a good look, Mug. You may not see another one for a long time. Goodbye, Frisco. Goodbye.
Well, if you're through having an affair with San Francisco, I'd like to get down to the ship.
Gee, you certainly are edgy, Pinky.
I'll try ya.
Say, I wish you guys had yap outside. I'd like to finish this letter.
Excuse me for living, please. Everybody is suddenly a prima donna. Come on, Lily Pons. I'll hold your hand down to the ship.
I'm sick of big cities. I wish I didn't have to go back to one. Irving loves Brooklyn. The only good thing about living in Brooklyn is you get into a subway and you're at Saks in 35 minutes. I got this suit there 2 years ago. $21.75. Still good to travel in.
That's correct.
Suits have good value.
Would I like New York, Ruth? I've never been further than Seattle in my life.
You'd either love it or you'd hate it. My dream is to be able to live in the country. Try and tear Irving away. He's more than 15 minutes away from Prospect Park. He's miserable.
Well, that's the nice thing about marrying a boy from the town you grew up in.
Never knows Mapleton is unexciting, but you know everybody, and everybody knows you. It's like having a big, pleasant family.
We've got a farm all picked out for after the war. Bobby's father and my dad are going to help us get started. It's going to be their wedding present. It's the most beautiful farm in Exton County.
I've still got all my wedding presents stored away. You know, we never had time to set up housekeeping because we knew Alan would soon be going in. It's going to be wonderful to have our own place.
There wasn't any time for Bobby and me to get any presents.
What's it like, Ruth, to have a home of your own? A baby, a husband coming home every night. It's fine, Dorothy. I thank God every night for giving Irving and me 5 wonderful years. If we were home now and had our farm, I'd be canning and Bobby'd just be putting in the winter wheat. Instead of this.
Oh, you will, Helen.
We're all going to have homes and babies and good, peaceful lives. That's what all this is for. That's why they're leaving tonight to go out and... Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say that. It just slipped out.
I'm glad you said it. I'm tired of pretending we don't know. Myself and to each other. They're leaving tonight. They're getting ready now. Across the bay.
Why don't you try and get some good music, Dorothy? The Philharmonics.
And the heavy bombers, in spite of heavy enemy interception, blasted their way through the defenses of the city and pounded their objective. Returning pilots reported large fires raging in the heart of the factory district. In this last daylight raid, 100 of our bombers participated. 22 of our bombers failed to return.
Oh, God, if they don't come back. If they don't come back.
Perhaps God will be good to us, Helen. I like to think he knows how little we've had, how we've only begun to live, and how much we love them.
I don't think I can bear it. I don't think I can bear it.
Now, Helen,
I'm not brave and strong. All the things this war is about. I know them. But they're names. They're just names. Roosevelt, Churchill, London, Berlin, Moscow, Tokyo. There's something I read in the newspapers. They're not real to me.
Bobby's smile. His voice. The way he looks when he's asleep. That's real. That's my whole life. And now he's over there across the bay. And soon he'll be gone and there'll be nothing. Nothing as if he'd never been.
You had a year, Dorothy, and you've had a baby, Ruth.
But I've had so little. So little. Sometimes it's almost worse with a baby, Helen. It breaks my heart. He kisses his picture of Daddy every morning.
Sometimes when he laughs, it's Irving's laugh. When he turns his head to look at me, it's Irving. And I want to cry.
We're not alone. Somehow, I don't know why, but that helps. It'll help you too, Helen, after a while. In this hotel, in every hotel in town, I guess, in rooms just like this, there are girls like us. Waiting. Feeling the way we feel. Thinking the same things tonight. All the way through training, I sat in hotel lobbies and tourist camps, talking to other cadet wives. Always about the same things. Always with that same pain inside. And after a while, you begin to share the pain. It doesn't go, but it's helped. You'll see, Helen.
Better turn the iron off if you're through pressing, Dorothy.
Oh, yes, thanks. They were kind of cute the other night, weren't they? Like little boys trying to put something over on somebody.
Yes, knowing they hadn't. They knew we knew it was the last pass, don't you think?
Yes. Yes, I think they did.
What's that chow like back there?
I don't care what it smells like. I'm going after it.
Not for me. I'm going after a show.
Want some chow, Irv?
Too tired.
Hey, Pink, how about you?
No, I'm too beat for chow. When do we go again?
This afternoon, 1600.
Let's just sleep.
Hey, Al! Did you just come in?
Yeah, patrol.
See anything?
No. Say, we're hitting the sack till 1600. You got someone to call us in time for briefing?
You guys aren't going to sleep now, are you?
I sure am.
Unless the War Department put through a new order against sleep.
But it's Christmas, Irv. Today is Christmas.
Christmas?
No kidding.
Sure. Merry Christmas.
Well, what do you know? We flew right through Christmas Eve. Today's Christmas.
Well, get a load of Christmas, will you? Hey, I'm wide awake now. Did the mail come in yet, Chaplain? We got presents.
A whole truckload. Jump in. I'll take you over just down the road.
Hey, Pink, get ours, too. We'll be up in a minute. Thanks for tipping us off.
Not at all. It was never meant to be a secret, son.
Merry Christmas.
See ya.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, that's small.
Thank you, getting on stuff. You ought to be here now.
Hey, Pink, come right in.
Merry Christmas, sir.
Merry Christmas.
Anything else for me?
what's this?
See, where?
I don't feel here.
Look. Look, a new picture of my kid. But he's a big boy. Look.
Well, what's he wearing a sailor suit for? Does he think you're in the Navy?
Oh, kids that age wear sailor suits, Dopey. Boy, is he getting big, hey, look. What, fellas?
Oh, for heaven's sakes. My mother sends me a sweater. I bet if I were in the Lucius, I'd get a straw hat.
What's that piece of paper pinned on it saying?
Mrs. Havaraki, next door, says the nights are always cool. Mrs. Havaraki's the big weather expert on the street. How you doing, Al?
Oh, wonderful. I got a new shaving kit from Mother.
Yeah?
And a check from my dad. I wonder where he expects me to spend money around here.
I got a couple of letters and about six pieces from Dorothy I haven't opened yet.
My mother-in-law broke a heart. Two hankets.
Look at that, will you?
Hey, look. From my pa. A picture of our street. Barbershop. He painted it himself. Must have got up early every morning to do it.
Hey, your pop's not a bad artist.
Oh, he's one of the sweetest guys in the world. Isn't he, Al?
Yes, he is. No one but your dad would have thought of a present like that. Let me see it a minute.
He's got everything in there. The barbershop, the music store. That's Mrs. Havaraki, the sweater girl.
Right around the corner here is the bank.
Hey, Irv, right over this shop. This window here, yeah. That's my room. Oh, it's wonderful to see it again, isn't it, Al?
It sure is. When you write him, tell him how much I enjoyed it, will you?
I sure will.
Attention, fellas, we're going to put on our little clam bake. What do you say, huh?
Dedicate the show today to Lieutenant Irving Miller's mother-in-law. How is that, huh? Of course, you guys know what a mother-in-law is. That's the Gestapo with bloomers.
All right, we start the ball rolling by introducing a young lady who came all the way from South America and brought a famous drummer with her, our own G.I. Carmen Miranda. What do you say, fellas?
Brazilians found the chicka chicka boom chee. They like the sound of chicka chicka boom chee. It came down the jungle from the Amazon, where the natives meet everyone they greet, beating out of town, town. Boom chee boom chee boom boom chee boom chee boom. It don't make sense, chicka chicka boom chee. But it's a mess, chicka chicka boom chee. That's all you gotta say, big boy, to chase the jeans away. Chicka chicka boom, chicka chicka boom, chicka chicka boom, chicka chicka boom, chicka chicka.
She is so lovely. Her skin has the incomparably soft texture of a full-blown peach, fuzz and all. I'll tell you, fellas, you don't have to worry about beautiful girls because we have three of the most gorgeous gals came all the way from California to entertain us. Everybody knows them, the famous Andrew Sisters. What do you say, fellas?
Has begun. The Pennsylvania polka. Pick out your partner and join in the fun. The Pennsylvania polka. It started in Scranton, it's now number one. It's bound to entertain ya. Everybody has a mania to do the polka from Pennsylvania. Gone. There's a carefree, gay with love. start to kiss again.
Pennsylvania. That'll give you an idea of the kind of work I used to do. Well, fellas, we're going to get serious for a minute. You're going to hear an old song, one that you've all heard before. I'm sure you'd like to hear it again, especially today. Corporal Regan will sing Silent Night.
Are they coming in?
I can't get a buzz out of them.
Keep at it. I'll try operations.
Hello, 554. Over.
Get me groove switch.
Nothing but a lot of wind.
Groove operations.
Hello,
on 554, I can't raise them on the radio. Will you get the north strip? Maybe they can find them. 554, overdue. I get nothing here.
554, this is tower. Come in, 554.
take it. I can't keep my mind on that coffee.
Take it easy, Chief. Not too jumpy.
Jumpy? How's the time?
40 minutes overdue.
I didn't think Wing Victory'd ever get it.
Not by a long shot.
Coffee's ready. Who wants them?
I can't move.
Tower, this is 554. 554 to Tower. Over.
554, this is Tower. Over.
Is that it?
Coming in now.
Tower, this is 554. Just north of field. A wounded man aboard. Repeat, wounded man aboard. Left wheel and tire shot up bad. We'll make straight in approach. Over.
Roger, 554. Make straight in approach. Use landing lights over field for ambulance signal. Clear runway as soon as you can. Ambulance! Ship landing in trouble. Wounded man aboard.
Okay, crash truck, follow the ambulance!
Tower, this is 554. Don't know if left gear will hold in down position. Have ambulance ready when we stop rolling. Here we come. Out.
Clear the pattern.
All ships in area, this is Tower. All ships in area, this is Tower. Clear the pattern. I have ship on emergency landing. Ship on approach on emergency landing. All ships in area, clear the pattern immediately.
Get nose wheel down on ground right after contact. Use brake hard on right wheel. Keep her straight.
Wounded man to waist, otherwise we're okay.
Stretcher to waist window.
Kind of a hot spot up there, was it?
Yeah.
Well, you did a good job.
Waist guns, but everybody else is okay.
It's Pinky.
Left wheel's all shot. We'll have to get a new one.
That'll take some time, won't it?
When do you want her?
Tonight.
A couple of hours?
Yeah.
She'll be waiting.
I don't see how, but you're the boss.
Get it. Miss Aldridge.
Yes, sir.
That's another ambulance full. Get Lieutenant Michaels. I'm taking 5 minutes.
Yes, sir. This is about the worst day yet.
No, he pushed off a couple of minutes ago. I'll be out here if they want me.
Yes, sir.
Are you the chief, sir?
Yes?
My gunner's here. His name's Pinky, but Danny Scariano. He's pretty badly shot up. Lost a lot of blood before I could get down. Doctor, would you look at him yourself? I hate to ask favors, but he's from my town, and he's my friend.
All right.
So, we'll stick around for a few minutes. I have to wait for a replacement gunner before we go up again. Well, could you let us know, sir?
Wait out here. I'll be out as soon as I can.
Thank you, sir. Think you'll make it, Irv?
I'm no doctor, Alan. His eyes I'm worried about. That piece of flak got him right at the temple.
If that's it, I'd almost...
Take it easy, Al. We got him here pretty quick. Sometimes that makes all the difference. Come on, let's go over there and sit down. Don't knock yourself out. We got to go up again in a few minutes. Come on.
Something funny?
No, not really funny, Irv. I was just thinking of a day. It was only a little over a year ago. Pinky and Frankie and I sat in my backyard and waited for a letter to come. B-24 flew by. Remember, I said, "That's us in a little while, fellas. That's us." It sure was. Frankie's gone. Now maybe Pinky. I didn't realize then what it meant.
Look, Al, Al. It doesn't do any good to think like that. It doesn't even help Pinky. This is his job and our job, and we gotta finish it.
Yeah. You got any cigarettes?
I think so. Right, it's from Dorothy. I almost forgot about it. Hey, Irv.
What's the matter, Al? Bad news?
Oh. No, Irv, it's great news. I have a son.
What?
No kidding. She never said a word. She didn't want to worry me. I've got a kid, Irv. Look, 7 pounds. Looks just like me at a day old.
Hiya, Papa.
But it doesn't seem real. I guess it is all right.
Hey, Irv, when do they begin to know you?
Maybe I'll be treated with a little more respect now, huh?
Boy, are you lucky you ain't there to have to change his diapers in the middle of the night.
Al Shake, I'm very happy for you.
We gotta take off in 10 minutes.
Let's find the doc. Maybe he can tell us now.
What's the matter?
It just hit me, Irv. I'm afraid. I was never afraid before, but now I'm scared. I'm scared. I don't want to die now, Irv. I want to see my kid.
Listen, Stu. You ain't gonna die.
All you're feeling now is the regulation new fodder miseries. I'll be calling on you when you're at old AK with 3 grandchildren, eh?
Hey, hey, there's the doc. Come on. Hey, Doc, here we are.
Good news, gentlemen. Your friend's gonna be okay.
Thank God.
What about his eyes, Doc?
He's just so lucky it frightens me to even think about it. No, he's gonna be fine. Just a little weak from loss of blood, that's all.
Could we see him, Doctor, just for a minute?
Well, just for a minute. I'm flying him back to the base hospital. Hold it here a minute, men.
Hello, Pink. You had us worried.
You better bend down. His voice is very weak.
Don't talk, Pink. Irv and I just want you to know how happy we are. And I've got to tell you a big piece of news. I have a son.
I'm a papa, Pinky.
How about that? It's a deal.
I'm afraid we better let him go. He's pretty tired.
Okay. Bye, Pete.
So long, baby. See you tomorrow.
When we pull him through. I'm as pleased as you are. Good luck, fellas. So long, Doc.
That's a load off our minds. Say, what did Pink say when you told him about the kid? I couldn't hear.
He said, don't let anyone but my pop give him his first haircut.
We have the new gunner, sir, and the ship is ready.
Thanks, Bill Hauser. Okay, Irv?
Okay.
Wait a minute. Give me a pencil, will you?
What do you want with a pencil, Daddy?
Oh, shut up. I want to write a note to my kid.
Al, kids don't read till they're 8 years old. You got time with that letter.
Say, that's nice, Al. That's nice.
I want my kid to know how it was here today. The day I first knew he was born. The world will be better for our kids, Irv, huh?
At least let's try it out.
We're trying like nobody ever tried before.